By now you might be a little bit familiar with the PuTTY tool. It's a very simple tool, and actually it allows a very simple way to connect to your Linux servers. For now, what I'll do is I'll actually delete some profiles, and I'll only keep one profile. I'll delete the Linux server profile. I don't need it. I'll delete the Oracle profile. Fine. Let us connect to the root into this My Linux server. I'll give the root password. Now the first time when you connect to Linux, actually PuTTY is a character based interface. You cannot invoke the GUI interface. For example, in Linux we have Firefox, right? That's the browser that comes with the Linux. By the way, this is my Oracle Enterprise Linux, I think 6.5 version. Now let me try to start the Firefox. So you might see there is an error. Of course, there might be multiple errors because you need to configure the GUI in PuTTY in order to invoke the Linux GUI in the Windows machine. For this, we need to download a new tool which is known as Xming. So go to Google, just type Xming download, hit enter. You can click on the you click on this option, Xming download. I think we should get the download. Yeah, this is the Xming software. I think this is softonic.com, and click on this free download. I think it should be safe to download. I believe so. So it is actually asking us to sign in to download, but I would actually choose the alternative download. Okay, we can see that our download has started. Let me close all these windows. So Xming has been downloaded. I'll click on this exe file and we'll go ahead and install the Xming software. So let me minimize this window. Click on next. Next. Okay, I already had the Xming software. For the demonstration purpose, I uninstalled the Xming software and I'm reinstalling. So I am seeing this error, but if you are doing it for the first time, you might not see this error. I'll just click on yes and just click on next and then next. What you can do is you can choose this option, create a desktop icon for Xming and create a desktop icon for Xlaunch. There are two programs that will be installed, and then click on next, install. This will actually install the Xming software on your system. So I will not start the Xming software immediately, just click on finish. Now let us go to the desktop. You can see we have Xming and Xlaunch. So don't worry about Xlaunch. What you need to do is you need to start the Xming software. Just double click this software and you can see your system tray, your Xming server will be started. Sometimes it is hidden in this arrow. So you must see this Xming server which is running in the taskbar. In order to invoke the Linux GUI in Windows, you need to have this Xming up and running. Sometimes people forget to start the Xming. You just double click and it will start. There is no window or there is no start button you will see. So sometimes if you don't start the Xming and you try to work hard in Linux, it will be a problem for you to invoke the GUI interface. So in this lesson, what we have done is we have downloaded the Xming software and we have installed the Xming software. So in the next lecture, you will understand how to configure PuTTY in order to invoke the Linux GUI.